My extremely conservative boss just came up to a group of us, knowing we were Democrats, and yelled at us for 15 minutes on why our vote was wrong. What's the most uncomfortable situation you've faced at work? A couple of years ago, my boss took me out to lunch and out of nowhere decided to spend the entire hour explaining how he absolutely did not want to sleep with me. By the end, I was convinced that he absolutely wanted to sleep with me. I have made a list of the reasons I don't want to sleep with you. Number 1. OMG, you are so hot. Number 2. You smell like an angel holding kittens who are baking bread. Number 3. Invited to a board meeting, IT guy, and in the middle of the meeting two of the board members got into a fist fight. Turns out one guy was screwing the other guy's wife and he found out about it. It was hysterical. They got into the middle of the circular conference table and fists were flying. I looked at my VP and he said, just ignore it, it won't be in the minutes. Now I know why they lock the doors for meetings. Comma, just ignore it, it won't be in the minutes. They always cut the best scenes. I used to do promotional work for a bar. It wasn't said explicitly, but it was obvious that I wasn't supposed to promote to black people. When targeting colleges for college night specials, I wasn't supposed to go to the historically black college, which was the geographically closest to the bar. We also had a dress code and the bouncers were allowed to be more lax with white people, but had to uphold it strictly with black people. The worst was watching the black bouncers go along with this. They knew what was going on, but the general feeling was that's just how it is. This is sadly pretty universal. I have some connection to the club scene in Canada. Just replace black prejudice with Aboriginal prejudice. The most uncomfortable moment at work I've experienced happened about 4 years ago. I worked in manufacturing and there was a girl, let's call her Claire, that started working in our area after being moved around from area to area. She was always missing work for whatever reason, but was a good enough worker. Our area lead, who was also a great friend of mine, was always the jokester. We will call her Karen. Lately a lot of people had been getting their 90-day reviews. Toward the end of the day on a Friday, one of the big supervisors came over and told Claire she needed to see her. Karen says, oh, it's never good when the boss wants to see you at the end of the day. She was joking around, of course, because we all knew it was review time. We all, including Claire, laughed. Fast forward 30 minutes and we are cleaning up our stations to leave for the day. Claire walks back to her station and the big boss is close behind her. Karen exclaims, still jokingly, hey Claire, want me to help you clean out your desk? Claire looks at her with tears in her eyes. The big boss gives Karen the death stare, and we all awkwardly look around and try to look busy because it was quickly apparent that Claire actually was fired. Karen suffered from a lot of foot and mouth situations. I work at a German club. I have a buzz cut, so while I was serving some old German guys that asked which skinhead gang I was in, they were serious. A good friend of mine had a boss who took a pair of scissors, yanked up his underwear and snipped both sides. He then pulled his underwear out of his trousers and threw it at my good friend. I had a boss who grilled me for 20 minutes about if I liked him personally. Oh yeah, I worked with a guy called John who was an utter weirdo. Stuff John did: bring in pictures of himself in full military biohazard gear including face mask, large gun and knife, and show it to everyone who he could corner. Ate junk food every day but kept a load of really cheap vitamins and supplements that he would take while lecturing us on health 20 minutes after sucking down a couple of Big Macs. Apparently lost his previous job for texting female co-workers pictures of his dong. I worked with him and two others in a small office. Every single day he did something really awkward. Me and the other girl I worked with fully expect to see him on the news one night. I'm trying vainly to come up with a way that this man could somehow do something awesome with his skills, so that you could see him on the news for something awesome. But headlines like, man solves crime by sending dong pictures, just don't show up every day. One summer I worked at a golf course as a pro shop attendant. The pro shop is about 4 feet by 7 feet. One of the maintenance guys for the course asked me out for drinks, but I politely declined. This guy insisted on standing at the pro shop drinking a beer on the evenings I worked ever since, even when I refused to engage in conversation with him. Super awkward and uncomfortable, especially since I couldn't leave. I used to work for a guy that had a gambling problem and was cheating on his wife with the accountant. His wife would call me and ask me where we were sometimes. I would have to lie and say we were stuck in traffic as the sound of video poker machines chimed all around me. I would watch this guy blow more than I made all month in less than an hour. The business went under, obviously. Already said this in another thread. After Obama won the first election, my boss at the time fired everyone with a Obama sticker, magnet, etc. on their car. It was pretty awkward having to watch 38 guys clean out their desks at once. So this morning a co-worker and I were happily talking about how Obama won. My conservative boss passes by us, stops, and says, "Frick both of you. Neither of us voted for Obama, save for an upvote on Reddit yesterday, because we live in Canada." If he said it with a bit of humor, it would not be bad, but if he was totally serious, boo. A 12-year-old student asked to talk to me in private at school. He told me that his mom lost her job and they needed to find a place to spend the winter. He told me that his mom wanted to know if they, mom and two boys, could live with me and that he was supposed to go home and tell her my reply. This happened today. I posted this elsewhere, but an 8-year-old boy punched me in the stomach while I was carrying their drinks and his parents thought it was cute. It was terribly awkward that I had to still smile while having thoughts of throwing the kid off the overpass. Should have accidentally dropped the drinks on his head. If he didn't punch you, he wouldn't have had caused it. I accepted an invitation to give an informal lecture to high school enriched math class last year. I turned on my graphing calculator and plugged it onto the TV screen. The TV was immediately filled with the graph of a large phallus my friend graphed as a joke the day before. Played it off as a glitch, but the teacher clearly knew it was polar graphing. Worked at a really big human rights nonprofit. First day on the job, I was so busy with my work I had forgotten to take lunch. Around 2 p.m. my boss comes around, asks me if I had taken lunch. I tell her no. She then says, "My god, go take a lunch. This isn't some sort of a US internment camp." I stayed quiet, and eventually she told me to go home early because I was doing such a great job. From then on, people started to call me the quiet Asian guy instead of the new guy. At first I thought you were defending the rights of big humans. First day on the job. Took a career best dump in the women's toilet, mistaking it for the men's toilet. Smiled at hot girl on the way out and instantly became aware of my crime. Stank the place out due to a very high protein diet. Marked my territory like winner that day. Still not as bad as punching a 4-year-old. I was with my ultra-conservative boss on election night 2008. We were driving along a empty stretch of highway in South Texas when the results were announced on the radio. He turns to me and says, "My wife studies these things and she thinks Obama might be the Antichrist." He was dead serious. Sadly, this guy was an executive in a pretty sizable company. Not the most awkward, but it was pretty awkward and just happened. Our supervisor sent an email to our entire department congratulating one of our employees on a promotion she had applied for, said to say goodbye and her last day would be the end of the week. Several moments later, she sends an email saying to please disregard the previous email, and why she's staying with us. The person apparently didn't get the promotion. She was turned down. It was something like her third time applying. She wasn't there that day, comes in the next day, sees the email and is mortified. A few people ask her about it, and she just completely ignores them. Then one lady comes up and has this exchange. "Lady, so what's up with that email? Did you get that promotion? Not promoted. That email should have never gone out. L.O. So you're staying with us. That's great. N.P.L. So, how was your weekend? N.P. Crappy. L. Crappy. Y. N.P. I don't want to talk about IT." About 5 minutes later, she started crying at her desk and left for the rest of the day. I sit very close to the person in question and had to sat here cringing the entire time. I work at a private school where I'm underpaid, overworked, no health benefits, no retirement benefits, and I've only heard one positive thing about my performance this year from an admin. They also expect 100% faculty participation in a yearly fundraiser to give money to the school. Where I work, already underpaid, no health benefits, no retirement. At my old job, my manager said that he would give me a half day off for my grandfather's funeral as a personal favor from him to me. Company policy actually entitled me to a week off. Working at the department store today, customer tells me she's having a bad day and needs some help picking out gifts to cheer her up. I start to say, "I'm sorry you're having a bad day, I'd be happy to help you find some fun things to brighten your spirits," but she cuts me off and says, "It's gonna be 4 more years of bad days with that Nia still in office." I choked on my words and she turned to me with an exasperated sigh and said, "Oh, do you love F?" Completely flabbergasted, near tears, and furious, I began to say yes I love my F, but she cut me off again with her hands waving in my face and called me a F-loving Nia. She then told me that I'm what's wrong with this country and turned heel to walk right back out the door. I wish I hadn't been at work because I had a lot to say. Whoa, that's a textbook case of things escalating quickly. In class, a girl made a statement to the effect that she couldn't help but feel that black people who speak in Ebonic sound less intelligent to her, that she was always taught a certain vernacular for proper English and she didn't understand why they couldn't speak the same way. She went on and on about it and you could tell she wasn't intentionally being racist and genuinely thought others would agree with her. There was one black girl in the class who broke out in tears. She explained how hard it is being away at school and living in the dorms with white girls. Her Ebonics was the way she spoke with some of her friends and family and it's hard for her to immediately want to respond one way but have to stop and rethink her response so her friends who don't use the same terms understand her. It was heart-wrenching. Thankfully the teacher handled it amazingly. She turned it into a lesson about how we all make judgments based on race even if we don't act on them and that there are many variations of the English language and someone who understands more than one actually has a better grip on how English can be used. I'm so appreciative of that teacher and how she handled the situation. She on the spot was able to turn around a discussion that escalated to offending a fellow student to the point of tears into a life lesson we all could walk away with. A man I had never seen before yelled at me for half an hour in front of an entire supermarket where everyone was too shocked to say anything. He claimed I had suggested sour cream and chive flavored chips to him knowing his pregnant wife was lactose intolerant. Then he called me a W for about 2 minutes before security came. I work in bulk food filling bins of sweets. He was just crazy. I sit by two very conservative guys at my job. I am a moderate Democrat in a very conservative state. I spent the better part of 8 hours hearing them go off on how the world is essentially coming to an end and the American people have essentially killed America for their children and grandchildren. They insinuated that when we roll back jobs, because we will have to fire people due to Obama, any registered Democrat should get canned first so they can live off welfare like they want to. They indirectly accused me of being a baby killer and a communist and were basically being a schatz. One, who goes to my church, suggested that anyone who voted for Obama should be excommunicated, as they put this world in front of the next. It was not a fun day today. Holy smokes. Talk about going into hysterics. Maybe under Obamacare they could afford some tranquilizers. I feel your pain. I work in the temporary staffing industry, which is poised to take a serious blow once the Affordable Health Care Act takes effect. Today one girl unfriended every Democrat from her Facebook while others could be heard cursing Obama and liberals for ruining the country. It was like being in an office full of children. I just kept the fact that I voted for Obama to myself. I can guarantee I'll get the same lecture tomorrow at work. First day back as a waiter since the election. It's a small family-run restaurant in the south and the owner were very open about supporting Romney, even to the point of putting Romney literature on the newspaper table. I don't mind the ranting. Knowing that my man is in office, and theirs isn't, I'll just stand there with a stupid little smile on my face. A week ago my boss asked me if I wanted to have his job when he switched departments. I was really excited and said yes. Then he asked me out. I explained that I had a boyfriend and that it was against the rules. In response, he told me my boyfriend didn't need to know. We were facing the possibility that top administrators might be doing some layoffs. My boss called a staff meeting and ordered us each to hand to her, in writing, a piece of paper identifying which 3 fellow staff members we thought ought to get fired, and why. This was mandatory. When the layoffs actually came out, It was my supervisor who actually had her position eliminated, although she ended up taking another position instead. I quit. I had hated my job there for 4 years and felt the need for a change. Was working at a drama academy, and one of the director instructors kept making outrageously lewd comments to me, and patting my rear. I asked him to stop, then complained to the head of the school. She replied that because he was a gay man and I was female, it didn't mean anything and he was just pushing my buttons. Have you ever heard of a situation like this? Would you consider it harassment, or not? The most uncomfortable time I had with a boss was in a previous job. Our art director left for another job, and no one was officially in charge in our department. I was next in line, sort of, and now the only one who worked during the morning. Others worked afternoon, evening. So the manager and the owner of the company called me in for a meeting in the manager's room. We didn't have boardrooms, but the manager's room was quite cramped. Not sure why we did it there, so they asked me to be the new art director. This actually sounded good. I was interested in it, and asked about specific duties. I assumed that I would do, being the art director. I remember one was ordering paper stock, another I wanted to reorganize and clean up the art room. I was told I wouldn't be allowed to do those things. I asked what type of raise I would be getting. I wanted at least $2 HR more. I thought I was lowballing it. The previous art director was making quite a bit. I was nowhere near that wage. Plus they had her entire wage to work with, since they weren't hiring anyone to take over. The answer I got from the manager was, "We don't give raises here." The shock on my face must have been more evident than I thought, because the owner suddenly clears his throat and tries to do some damage control. It's not that we don't give raises, per se, but due to the economy, blah blah balls blah blah. The manager explained to me that we need someone who is responsible for that department. After that, it was just really uncomfortable in that small room with these two people and the ridiculous crap they were saying. Needless to say, I didn't take the position, which the manager later lied to a few people and said that I took it, but it didn't work out. They never did promote anyone to that position, and so the department ran itself, more or less. The manager later explained that they didn't need an art director, and that was her plan. So that because the previous one left, we might all get a little bit of a raise from this. That never happened either. I work at a call center for a company that sells vitamins. Every single night I listen to old people who all are avid Romney supports be about Barack Hussein Obama and how he's a dirty liar and ruining this country, and they always ask me my religion and my political views. And I have to lie and tell them I'm a good Catholic Republican. In reality, I'm a dirty atheist liberal man s. Tonight I am drinking their sweet sweet conservative tears as they cry about Romney's defeat, and dang do they taste sweet. Yay atheism, liberalism, manslutism. I'm a physical therapist assistant, and yesterday I almost had two patients get into a political fight with each other. I had just finished with one patient and was starting my next when they started talking about the election. One was an Obama supporter and the other was a diehard Romney supporter. I had known this beforehand because I often stood silently while she expressed her adamant dislike of Obama during her treatments. Weird thing is, outside of her political views, she's one of my favorite patients. Luckily it ended in abrupt and awkward silence between the two of them, and I merrily went on with what I was doing. When it comes to politics with my patients, I avoid it like the plague. I have really large tea and am quite short. I work in a profession where I am usually the only girl in the room, and I work with a lot of awkward guys. I do a good amount of field work inspections etc, so people are always reaching for hardware etc, and needless to say, accidental boob grazes happen a lot. If it's possible, the guys get even more awkward after it happens. I had to explain a co-worker that voted for Romney that Obamacare was simply health insurance, not socialized medicine, because his rationale for voting for Romney was that he didn't want to have to wait 3 months to see a doctor, like in Canada. This wasn't actually that awkward, just dumb. At my place of work, I was attempting to leave a small room as my female manager was entering, in which she then cornered me, brought her body and face very close to mine, and in the most serious voice said, "God, I wish I could see what's under that uniform." She then smacked my butt and left, scarred forever. Also, from time to time when I enter a room, she will poke my sides while making the noise of a fire truck. when my stepmom, who owned a pet store, had a breakdown. At first she was screaming at people but then dissolved into a dribbling mess in front of all the employees and there were some customers. I helped her into the back area where there was a pet groomer area, since it wasn't open and it was isolated from everywhere else. The till had like a few bucks missing or something and a few of us offered to pitch in our spare change because whatever, it's nothing, which is what set her off. After calling my stepdad and helping her get into the car, she was still crying. I basically closed shop and sent everyone home. It was the middle of winter, and she got my stepdad to drive home by convincing him that there was still an hour of the store being open and leaving me behind to grab a bus. Except I used my bus change to fill the missing few dollars from the till. So after an hour of walking home, I come inside covered in snow and my stepmom BF me for not kicking my boots off before coming in. She then proceeded to tell me that she got off the phone with her employee that was off work, who is also her friend, and they began to assume I was the one who stole it, telling the person you're living with that you are quitting and they are family is awkward as frick. My brother dated a girl for 5 years until they broke up after an ugly fight. About 2 years later the girl's sister got a job at my office, on the same floor as me. I had met her several times at family gatherings. Until I got a promotion I saw her every day, but I never talked to her. We just sort of avoided each other all the time and it was very uncomfortable. My most uncomfortable situation? Being Republican and realizing Mitt Romney was a dumbbub the first time I saw his face. Probably going to get buried, but getting sent flowers, 18 red roses and a balloon on my birthday from a guy who had left 2 months prior, whose pregnant wife still worked in my department. She was out that day because it was their wedding anniversary. Everyone assumed they flowers were from my boyfriend. I let them hold this assumption. Told him later. His response? Well, at least it looked like I sent you some really expensive flowers. Haha. That guy has still been trying to contact me after over 3 months of silence. Also, the time a different married guy, whose wife was also employed with us, cornered me and tried to kiss me in an elevator. I ducked under his arm, mashed the elevator buttons until the doors opened, and fled. Also the time my boss randomly called me into his office to tell me that I'm really cute and not to worry about jealous co-workers. Eek. For the record, there are reasons that I, unfortunately, didn't report the above to our acting HR rep. I spent a couple years working with a girl who was head over heels for me that I was completely uninterested in. She just wasn't my type. No matter how subtle or blatant I was in my rejections, she would shrug it off whether it doesn't matter if I like you and continue her pursuit. I would stop talking to her for a couple months at a time when it got really bad. Eventually I switched shifts and basically stopped seeing her altogether, since I would come in after she was already gone. Recently ran into her again, and her crush is still there, but she seems much more mellow about it. Whoa, that is inappropriate. If there is an HR department you should report it. That isn't right. The way I see it is if I am entitled to my opinion then other people are also entitled to theirs. I don't have to like it or agree with it. Last week a co-worker mentioned gas prices were decreasing, which another co-worker proudly replied, "That's because that N wants back in office." All 5 other co-workers agreed. I work in North Dakota. I don't belong here. Our plant manager hated Obama, constantly lectured people in meetings about how they should vote, and curse Obama and Democrats to any and all who would listen. My response was to write "Proud Democrat" on my hard hat in big letters on all sides. Every time I had business with him I was expecting a discussion about that, but he never said a word to me. Oddly enough, I got along with him pretty well, even though he was pretty abusive to everyone else whenever the least little thing went wrong. Walked in on my male manager eating out a female colleague in the back room. But this was at a Hungry Jack's in Australia in 2009. The burgers are better at Hungry Jack's. Depending on what state you live in, your boss can fire you for disagreeing with his political views. It's better to have multiple people report him to HR in case something goes down. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. bye for now.